Assalamualaikum, my name is Widi Mutakin. This is the fifth part of the video tutorial series. In case you stumble upon this video directly, be sure to check out the previous videos before moving on. The tutorial series is about developing augmented reality product from A to Z using Blender, Unity, and Vuforia. These tutorials are all based on my previous experience developing my own augmented reality product, which is this flashcards, Arabic letters and numbers augmented reality. Basically, a flashcards to help children learning Arabic alphabet using augmented reality. I leave links below in the description if you like to learn more or purchase the flashcards from Amazon. We will continue texturing our model Carney. We've done texturing everything before except the head part. So let's get down to it. We've pretty much covered all of the techniques and shortcuts in the previous videos, so I won't be explaining too much in this video again. First, make sure you use texture draw brush, and then let's add red color for the inner part of the mouth. Next, let's add a bit of orange. This will be the position of the teeth later. Then some pink color near outside of the mouth. Next, we need to blend these colors a bit. We can use the soften brush. Be very careful though, this brush is CPU intensive as it basically adds blur to the texture. Okay, now we need to add some shading. Pick red color from the inner mouth area that we have before and make it a bit darker. Change the blend mode to multiply. Reduce the transparency by setting the strength to only around 0.2. Okay, now we need to stroke this area. After we have something like this, we need to add some segment lines to make it more believable. To do that, we can add tiny triangles like this. Okay, now by using the smear tool, we can drag these pixels towards the center. Now we need to add the throat and the uvula. Just use the dark red color. Zoom in a bit and draw something like this. Last but not least, let's add some dark green dots on top of the head. Okay, we are now officially finished doing texture. Now when you save the Blender file, you actually not saving the texture file. This is something you need to keep in mind. To save the texture file, open the UV image editor and make sure you see the image. If not, go to this menu and choose Material Diffuse Color. Okay, to save the file, go to Image, save as image. Make sure it is PNG as it is a lossless image format, so you will not get any quality degradation when saving the image. Leave this as RGB in 8-bit per channel. Then slide this all the way up to make the file size as small as possible. Click in here and name the file carny_texture.png. Then hit the Save as Image button up here. Okay, now go back to object mode. Notice we lose all of our texture. Well, actually not. As you can see in here in the texture tab in the properties panel, Blender already load this texture we saved before to Carny's material. But why the texture not showing up? To see the texture in object mode, you need to do two things. First, go to 3D view properties and in display section, change the multi texture to GLSL. Okay, the texture of our model is not showing now because we don't have any light object present in the scene. To avoid the need of any lighting, we can make the material of the object to shadeless. Shadeless means that the material will not be affected with any lighting condition and will always show the diffuse color as it is. Okay, so now we can see the textures. Before we can move on to the rigging process, we need to duplicate the tooth and reposition them. To do this, go to edit mode, make sure nothing is selected. Now to select the tooth only, you can do this easily by hovering your mouse over a vertex in that tooth and then press L. This will select all linked vertices. Now we can move it, rotate it, or scale it if you need to. And next, to duplicate the tooth, we can press Shift D and move the cloned geometry to any location you want. I will speed up the video as the processes are identical for all of the teeth. Next, let's place the leaves so they are attached to the trunk. I will speed up the video again as we already discussed all of the techniques before. Alhamdulillah, we now have a good looking 3D model complete with texture ready to be rigged. We'll continue to the rigging process in the next video, inshallah. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Wassalamualaikum.